outside, I extend my hearty thanks and warm welcome to all. So, before going to the classes, I want to have a discussion with you regarding the question pattern and the style of writing, what our assistant director last time he has informed me. So, I think today I will start regarding the last questions, and we will also some important questions which we have covered already. So, am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. So, I think you have already know about the pattern of questions. Question kotha kon janicho ki samasta?
I guess sir.
Acha
poriya kebe
hobo?
December. Hello? Sir,
December hobo na?
December. Yes sir,
December de achi. Now it will be June, so you have 6 months more. Okay, still then
yes sir,
we will discuss something regarding the questions, then after we will again go through our chapters. Okay, so jette bele mu dekhili tamara questions, I am also a IGNO evaluator and I have seen, so since last 3 years I am evaluating. So gotiye kotha pila mane amara panchta question asuchi. Usha from West Bengal.
Yes sir.
Yes, you try to listen me. If you have any difficulties, kindly ask me any question. I have no hesitation. Okay. So
okay,
whenever we will go through the questions, we will see there was a instructions to write minimum 5 answers. Okay, Usha, we have to write 5 answers, and each answer will carries the marks 20 marks. So 20 marks means we have to write 5 marks from each section A and B, and each section it is compulsory to write minimum 2. So what we will do, that is the vital issue. So he has given the instructions to write not more than 500 words. Okay, my dear friends.
Okay, sir.
So we have to write, Sharmista, we have to write within 500 words. That means you have to write 4 meters. Anusaya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me, amne kon kariba? Charita page minimum likhiya. 4 pages means, mane, there are 2 pages. First, second, then third, fourth. Did you understand my point or not? Anusaya?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amar charita page likhiya. Charita page means kon hobo? Amar jodi ame white paper anima, tale tale both side 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Only 4 pages we have to write. So try to write within that pages and don't try to exceed that page. Why I am telling so? You can also write more pages, I have nothing to say, but time will not cooperate with you because we have only 3 hours. So my dear friends, try to write only 4 pages and give most stress to the short notes, because in short notes generally the students secure good marks, even 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10. So you will get automatically 16 marks or 18 marks in one question, whereas in one long question examiners generally gives up to 15 or 16. So are you clear what I am telling, sir, mister?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then,
yes, sir.
Then the second question comes, writing must be very simple, lucid and heart-touching. So It is one thing I do want to make you clear. Don't try the style of writing which is in your IGNU books, because it will be very difficult for your part to write these sentences. So what I am telling, so in every sentence, try to write very simple, very lucid and heart touching. Suppose I will tell one sentence. Yesterday I went to Bhubaneswara, met Samista Sahu, and we have made regarding the exam pattern. So this is the style of writing by which the examiner can read without any difficulties, first thing. Second thing, there will be no problem to write the simple sentence by a learner, by a student. Okay, then you will give much importance to the direct question. Suppose I am telling one question, what it is here, just 1 minute, wait. You see one question is here. The first question, what explain the different facts by which the Renaissance created the conditions for the making of the modern world. Suppose there is a question, discuss the causes and results of French Revolution, or discuss the various causes of the Russian Revolution, or discuss the various important points of American Revolution. If such type of questions are there, try to write at first, because it is clear and you will not be pondered what I will write and what I will not write. So this is all about the question pattern, how you will write. So if you want, we will go to the new lessons, or if you want, we can also discuss the previous unit we have discussed regarding the question and answer. So the ball is in your court. If you want, we will discuss, or I will go to the new lessons. What you want, you can tell me. Thank you. Anusaya.
Yes, sir.
What we will do? Whether you want to discuss about the questions, or we will go to
the question discussion.
Question discussion. Regarding Samista from Paradeep.
Yes, sir. Question discussion.
Question discussion.
Yes, sir.
Then others.
Again, sir.
Lipika Rani.
Yes, Lipika, sir.
What do you want?
Yes, sir.
Question answer, or yes, we will go to new lessons?
Question discussion.
Question discussion. Okay. We will come to the first unit one. Okay. So you see what are the questions here. There is
sir,
no question, I think. I mean, first, there is no question. What I
unit
think?
After unit 3.
Okay, I am going. Unit 3. Critics of Enlightenment. Okay. Some exercises for this block. Okay, yeah. Renaissance and the idea of the individual. How did developments in trade and commerce create condition for the Renaissance? First question. Second was, what was the process through which religion began to lose its dominant position in European society? Then the Enlightenment. So you see, first you will see Renaissance and the idea for the individual. Here it is a question. How did development in trade and commerce create conditions for the Renaissance? So, trade and commerce. Acha. Hmm. trade commerce, I think this position is not here, but question is there. Acha. Okay, I have taught it from what did happen, Anusha?
Trade and commerce is not available in Renesa.
Renesa, okay. So yes, I have gone through to teach you the Renesa. I have gone through a new book. Okay, so we will see how trade and commerce create conditions for the Renesa, and I think this is not here. Okay. So
yes.
What we will do, I will see invention of the idea is there, developments of Italy is there, new education, human, new groups, lawyers and notaries is there, new education is there, print, secular openings is there, religion and moralism is there. So one thing you do it. Tomorrow I will tell about this question, where I will find and tell you, because we will not spoil our golden time. So we will go to the next question. What was the process through which religion began to lose its dominant position in European society? What are the process? So science, Karl Marx.
Sir, previous year question anujayi am search korthile chari ta question paithile renesa upare se khali new modern world kemti hele question sub thila je
explanation
sub khali one type of question
nani o sabole one type of question asuchi.
हाँ केवल गोटे हो जो डिफरेंस थिला जे रेनेसा ओ एनलाइटमेंट में चिन्हित रहे हो जो राइट ए नोट ऑन कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रेनेसा एंड एनलाइटमेंट इन द मेकिंग ऑफ न्यू वर्ल्ड
सुनो गोटे जिन सुनो हम पाखरे हां सुनो हम पाखरे अछि साइंस वर्सेस रिलीजन हां ओके हां हम पाखरे अछि साइंस वर्सेस रिलीजन यू सी 2.4 पेज हो छि 2.5 कॉन्स्टेंटिनोपल वाज द मेन कॉज ऑफ रिनेसा इन वर्ल्ड और सो टू से इन इटली बर्तमान आम देखा व्हाट वर द फैक्टर्स ओ हाउ वाज द प्रोसेस थ्रू व्हिच रिलीजन बिगन टू लॉस इट्स डोमिनेंट पोजीशन अच्छा व्हाट आर द पोजीशन ऑफ रिलीजन ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड हु कैन से अनुसय आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड अ डिस्कशन विद यू व्हाट आर द पोजीशन ऑफ रिलीजन एट दैट टाइम हु कैन से
And the people believed in science, but there is a new rage about the religion.
Okay.
So many thinkers and viewers.
No, Samista.
Yes, sir.
What is your opinion? What is the position of religion? And why it lost its dignity and own position? Why religion? Religion, why it lost its position? Can you say anything? Pushpanjali from Dharasugra. Pushpanjali, I think.
Yes, sir.
Then what is why religion lost its position during Renaissance? Why did that? Because I am totally clear. No, I am telling you it again. I am telling it. Just I will highlight some important points, and you have to go through the lessons because 6 months is there, it is enough for you. Mula jinish hala, what did happen? From the beginning of the history or a human society to 5th century AD, it is known as the ancient period. 50 to 15, it is known as the medieval period. And 15 to onwards, it is the modern period. And during the medieval period, the religion lost its position. Jaha thila ago, jaha 15th century purbaru jaha thila, it lost its own position. Kahiki, se samare kevalo, church, bishop, father. Regarding this, religion was there and teaching was given importance. But when the new philosophers like yes sir, no, I have already told you Peter Abelard, I have told different kinds of the philosophers, they opened different kinds of thought, they gave a new thought to the society, and that's why the people didn't give any importance. Suppose I will tell about the Mona Lisa painting, I will tell about the Saint George, then I will tell about the printing machine, the role of the printing machine, humanism, new education, lawyers and notaries, they played a significant role. They played a significant role to bring a changes in religion. So it is the main cause. What was the process through which religion began to lose its dominant position in European society? The new philosophers who came, they gave a different vision. They gave a new thinking to the Europeans. That's why religion lost its position. So you have to write what are the how the period is divided into three parts. How the religion of the church played a significant role and giving different kinds of superstitions to the human mind. And at the beginning of the modern world, so to say, a new thought entered. And the religion totally lost its dominant position. Okay? Okay, my dear friends.
Okay, sir.
How, any problems, anything you want to know, you can raise any question. Any question? Goodly, Pushpandali.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any question? Huh? Did you understand what I told?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we will go to the next question. Okay. Yes, sir. The Enlightenment, how was the essence of the idea of progress as espoused by Enlightenment thinkers? So, what I have told you during this question, so the Enlightenment thinkers, what they give new to the society. Okay, so it is not a new thing, it is interrelated with unit 1, number 2 question and unit 2 and 1 question. Okay, so the next question is, how did Enlightenment thinkers understand the relation between the science and religion? We have already discussed the science and religion 2.5. You will go for it. Okay. Anusaya?
Okay, sir. Okay.
We will go for it. Okay, we have seen,
yes, sir,
what is science and what is the religion. How superstition played a vital role during medieval period, but how science changed the notion of the individual. Okay, so then the critics of Enlightenment, what are the main ways in which romantics differed from the Enlightenment thinkers? I have already discussed with romantics. I have told the romantics. What is the idea of the romantics? Romantics like Rousseau sought salvation in the natural order. What they have told. Okay, so then the enlightenment understanding of man, society, history, and knowledge did not go unchallengedly. The enlightenment thinking from its conception of truth, science, and reason to its belief in the idea of progress. The enlightenment had represented the present as an advance upon the past. The enlightenment. The present is an advance upon the past. The romantics, by contrast, they saw it in the deterioration of the humanity. So romantics, what they have told, that it is the deterioration of the past. Okay. Did you understand what I am telling? Romantics, they thought the present condition was the deterioration of the past. Okay. So you will see the romantics, how it differs from the enlightenment, enlightenment thinkers. The enlightenment, they opine, we are in a state of progress. But the romantics, they have opined that we have a deteriorated condition from the past. Anusaya. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. How did Karl Marx and the Frankfurt School advance the idea of initiated by the enlightenment thinkers? So what they have told, what is the ideology of Karl Marx and what was the idea of Frankfurt School of advance? So my dear friends, what you will do before, first you go through the questions, what you will write, what are the main points you have to write, you have to note down first, because time is too long for you. You have much time. So first, regarding the first question, second question, third question, first you mentally prepared what you will write. What are the main points? What are the, what the romantics they opine, and what are the opinions of the enlightenment? What are the romantics thinkers, and what are the enlightenment thinkers? So by this, first you have made a plan, chalk out a plan. Then after you will try how to highlight these points. So I think there is no difficult question in this part. If you have anything, you can tell me.
Sir, how did the enlightenment influence the socio-economic order in Europe? How can we write? Okay.
You see?
Socio-economic order in Europe.
Yes, I am telling you. So you have asked me a beautiful question regarding what happened after the renaissance of the society, socio, religious, and economic life of the people. This is the question I think. Anusaya, or who asked me this question?
Yes, sir.
Who asked me this question?
Sir, I, Anusaya.
Anusaya, okay. So, my dear friend, you see, first you will see what is the main obstacle or what is the main problems of the society before Renaissance. And Renaissance, how it brought a tremendous change in society, social, economic, and political life. Here we will see, in society, you will see the philosophers saw scientific knowledge as a power. Those who tried to challenge, they told they are the enemies of humankind. Before Renaissance, the society was full of superstitions, full of dogmas, full of blind beliefs. They simply believed that the key how to go to heaven, the key is with Pope. So they simply compel the individual to obey it. But after Renaissance, a new horizon, a new development has come to the every mind of the individual. Accordingly, the society changed. And at the same time, the philosophical thinkers, they enlightened the mind of the people. So automatically the society, the individual, they didn't blindly believe to the religion. So accordingly the society changed. So before that, you see, religion pai ame kon korche gura paisa kharcha korche ebo lokmane agur madhya kharcha karuthile tame chinta kara gote kotha mu kauchi jodi bartamana jugare tame gote mandir ku jibo you have to spend not less than 100 rupees nadia gote kinibo 30 tanga kadal de de nabo minimum 40 tanga 70 tanga dupali pocket nabo minimum 40 ki 50 tanga habo tame tamaro wife hajon ta misik jibo and you have to pay the expenditure of the fuel. And in the temple, you have to pay not less than 10 rupees. So it is more than 100 rupees. So, philosopher manangara mata hala, for what reason, for what purpose you are going to the temple? And temple is the only medium just we are going to get some relief of the mind, nothing else. In your home, you will get such life of pleasure, such life of peace, mental peace in your home, because every home is a temple. Yeah, this is the philosophy, or this is the thinking of the philosophers, what they have infused in the individual mind. So automatically, the economic crisis of the individual gradually wiped out. ତମେ ଯଦି ମାସକୁ ତିନି ଥର ଯିବ ତମେ ଚିନ୍ତା କର ତମେ 500 ରୁପିସ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ ହଉଥିଲା ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ସେଠୁ ତମେ ଏଇଟା କ'ଣ ହେଲା ଅଟୋମେଟିକାଲି ସେଭ୍ ହେଇଗଲା ହେଲା ସେମିତି କ'ଣ ହେଇଛି ନା ଗୋଟେ ନ୍ୟୁ ଗ୍ରାଜୁଆଲି କ'ଣ ହେଇଛି ଏ ସୋସାଇଟି ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ହେବାରେ ଲାଗେ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ସୋସିଆଲ କଣ୍ଡିସନ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ୟୁ ସି 2.7 ପେଜେସ୍ ମେନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ already it is written, fighting the dogmatism of religion and the institutional structure was an important pillar in the struggle for freedom. So people got freedom, what Rousseau has written in his Social Contract, man is born free, but everywhere there is change. Then the other things is that Montesquieu spoke, when legislative power is united with the executive power in a single person. So it is about the political change of the society. The Montesquieu told the executive, legislative, and judiciary should be changed, and it should not be in the one hand of the person. Okay. Formulation of laws, education of laws, interpretation of laws, each wing checks the powers of the other, is only one dimension of a system committed to protecting the liberty of its citizen. So it is all about the equality, liberty, and fraternity. And it is all about the Montesquieu that three powers should be separated from each other. Any question, please? So hello, another interesting sentence, Anusaya. The influence of enlightenment is evident as much in the modernization theories that dominated the study of societies in the mid-20th century as it is in the social reforms movement in the 19th century India. So this is all about what you have asked, the social, economical, and political influence on the society during the Renaissance movement.
Okay.
Anything?
Yes,
Anusaya?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Then comes to the which page? Which questions you want to know? Then you come to the 11 pages. 11 pages. Usaja from West Bengal. I think you have well understood. Usaja.
Yes, sir.
Do you understand what I have told?
Yes, sir.
What I have discussed, or any questions with you, you can ask.
Sir, we can discuss the assignment questions.
Assignment questions?
Yes, sir.
assignment questions, which questions you tell me? I have no assignment questions in between. So how I will know? You can ask any question. Okay.
Hello.
Okay.
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଯଦି ଆମେ ସାର୍ ୟୁନିଟ୍ ୱାଇଜ୍ ଯିବା ସେଠି ତ ବହୁତ ସାରା କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଅଛି ତ ଆସାଇନମେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିଦେଲେ ଭଲ ହବ
ନାଇଁ ଥାଉ କ'ଣ ଅସୁବିଧା ଅଛି ଆମେ କରିବା କିଛି ଅସୁବିଧା ନାହିଁ ଆମର ବହିରେ ଯେତିକି କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଅଛି ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିଦେଲେ ତ ଭଲ ହବ ଟୁ ଆୱାର୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ଏନଫ୍ ଟୁ ଡିସ୍କସ ଟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଏ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ ଆଉ ତମେ ଯଦି କହୁଛ ଆସାଇନମେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଆଲସୋ ଆସ୍କ ମି ଆଇ ହାଭ୍ ନଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଟୁ ସେ ବଟ୍ କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମେ ଏମିତି ପଳେଇ ଗଲେ ସବୁ ଯାକ ସୁବିଧା ହେଇଯିବ ସବୁ ଯାକ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିଦେଇ ପାରିବା
ଓକେ ଓକେ ଠିକ ଅଛି
ସବୁ ଯାକ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିଦେବା ତାହେଲେ ଆମେ ପାଠ ଭିତରେ ପ୍ରଦର୍ଶନ କରିପାରିବା ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ବେଟର ୱାଟ୍ ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ୍ କ୍ଲିଅରଲି ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ହାଭ୍ ଏ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଯଦି ଆସାଇନମେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ କିଛି ରହିଗଲା ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ହାଭ୍ ଏ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ ଇନ୍ ମାଇ ଟୁମାରୋ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ୟୁ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଓକେ
ଓକେ ସାର୍
Okay, so next question is you come to the page 11. What do you understand by the state? Who can say?
Hello?
Hello, you can say what?
Hello?
Hello.
Sir, Hello. You asked the question, what is state? State is an organized political community under one government and state have five characteristics. I have not remembered the five and three of them was jurisdiction, public institution and authority. Sovereignty
territorial borders. These are the five basic characteristics of a state. So accordingly you will discuss over it. Okay. So hello. So
hello.
Society and society and a state both are interlinked. Society and individual both are interlinked. So how will it gradually progress? Then I have discussed really how you will understand the society. It comprises a set of institutions with ultimate control over the violence within a given territory, monopolizing rule making within the territory, develops the structures for the implementation of the rules, regulates market activity within the territory, then regulation and a distribution of essential material goods and services. These are the main points of the state. Okay, so the next question is did you understand or anything to know? The next question, write note on a liberal conception of the state. So what is the liberal conception of the state like Niccolo Machiavelli his book Prince, Thomas Hobbes, what they have given, what is the state? Then Thomas Hobbes offers brilliant analysis of the state and related issues to protect the people and of course their property. So the main important theme is that the duties of the state is that to protect the people and their property. This is the motto of the this is the duty of the state. Thomas Hobbes considered the state to be preeminent, means important, in social and political life. It is the state that gives to the individuals the chance to live in a civilized society, to live in a peaceful movement. Look, the state exists is an instrument to protect the life, liberty and state of the citizens. law holds categorically that the individual do not transfer all their rights to the state. It is the central to our understanding of the state. So the minimum duty of the state is how to protect its people, how to give, how to protect its prosperity, and how what it will do for the progress of the individual in the society. So it is different kinds of theories. Jenny Bentham and James Mill developed a systematic account of the liberal democratic state. So you will go and see page 2, 3, and 4, 5. These are all about the liberal aspect of the state. You can also see it. Then briefly compare the conceptions of the welfare state and minimum state.
Sir.
Okay, you can ask me.
Sir, liberal conception of the state, liberal view of the state are same, no? Liberal view of the state of state or liberal conception of state, same question?
Same. শুনো এটি তুমি কোন গোটে জিনিস গোটে জিনিস তুমি মনে রাখ ইগ্নোরে তুমি ভালো মার্ক নিশ্চয় পাইব নো ডাউট অফ ইট কাহিঁ না মুখ বহুত দেখিছি পিলা কেবে মোর মিনিমম হচ্ছে 70 আপ টু 90 পর্যন্ত মু দেইছি হ্যাঁ খোলা কথা মু কৌছি কিন্তু গোটে জিনিস তুমি বুঝিও চেষ্টা কর যেহেতু এ যে বহি জাগ তোমার ডিজাইন হয়েছি ইট ইজ ফর আইএস তুমি যদি আপর যদি তুমি চাইবো আইএস পাই মু তোমাকে নম্বর দেবি তোমাকে মু গাইড করিদেবি আইএস হো বা ওএস হো তুমি যদি দেব হিস্ট্রি অপশন যদি রাখুছ তাই টু কন্টাক্ট উইথ মি ওকে আই উইল গিভ ইউ দ্য ডিটেইল আইডিয়া এবং এ বই আর সে বই ভিতরে কোন ডিফারেন্স আছে মানে তুমি কইদিন হ্যাঁ তেমন এটা কিছু ডিফিকাল্ট কোশ্চিন নুহ ডিফিকাল্ট টাস্ক নুহ গোটে জিনিস আমি কেতে ফিলোসফর না মনে রাখিও পড়ব তাকে কেমিতে মনে রাখবা না সব জায়গা ফিলোসফর না আমি কোন করিবা না গোটে কাগজে টিপি দেবা এবং টিপি দেখি গোটে লাইনরে সে কোন করছেন ধন্য কালমার্কস কোন কহিলে জেমস মিল কোন কহিলে জেনি মেথম কোন করছেন এ তো না যাক যদি আমি এ হিস্ট্রি অফ গোটিং ইজ ডিফিকাল্ট দ্যাট ইজ নেম এন্ড ডেথ নাথিং এলস না নাই হিস্ট্রি কোন ডিফিকাল্ট আছে কি কিছু ডিফিকাল্ট না কেবল না এবং ডেথ যদি রক্ষিত আর কিছু মনে নাই এবং এ যে টপিক রে আছে তো না যাক টিকে ডিফিকাল্ট আছে কিন্তু সব জায়গা প্রত্যেক পাঠের ফিলোসফার না লাগা টিপি দাও করে কাগজে এবং গোটিয়ে সেন্টেন্স লিখিব ওয়ার দে হ্যাভ টু দেল তম পাঠা উচ অসুবিধা হবো না আর তোমাকে মু গ্যারেন্টি দেউছি পিলা মানে তুমি এই ধরে ওএস পে রেডি হো বা আইএস র সিলেবাস দেখ মু দিটা দেখিছি বলে কৌছি মু মানে আমার ক্লাস রে মু পিলা মানে এপরে বহুত থর মু গাইড বি করছি তেনু যদি তুমি নৌছ তাহলে তোমাকে ইগনোর মেটেরিয়ালস ইজ সাফিসিয়েন্ট এবং তোমাকে তা বাই দে আর কিছু কিছু বই কই দিবি পড়িয়া পি এন্ড তুমি অপশনাল রে ভেরি গুড মার্কস স্কোর করিব অসুবিধা কিছু নাই কিন্তু আমি টিকে ডিটেলস এবে তোমাকে মু কাহিনী যাচ্ছি প্রতি পাঠের কোশ্চিন সেটা কাহিনী যাচ্ছি না আমি গলে আমি আউট এগেইন আউট কোন যাব আম মুন্ডকে পেন দিই আমি সব জানিছি আমি সব করছি বাট লিটল বিট ডিসকাশন ইজ রিকোয়ার্ড ওকে
ওকে স্যার
ওকে
নেক্সট কোশ্চেন
হ্যালো
यस স্যার
ওকে ইদার এনি কোশ্চেন ইউ ক্যান আস্ক মি হ্যাঁ দেন দা হিয়ার আনাদার কোশ্চেন ইজ দ্যাট ওয়েলফেয়ার স্টেট এন্ড মিনিমাম স্টেট So I have told you what is the duty of the welfare state. We have already discussed regarding feminist theory, regarding Gandhi perspective on the state. Okay. then we can say what is that liberal state, Rousseau, Marxist, welfare state. You see the page number. 8. T.H. Green, first and the strongest advocates of the kind of a welfare state that Europe became familiar with it. So we have to remember this name, T.H. Green. So what is the main thing is that the welfare state, we would notice that it does not sanction the evolution of a market, but only a correction of its defects. So here what is the main motto of the philosopher? was that it always tries to reform its defects. ବୁଝା ପଡ଼ିଲା ନାହିଁ, ଯୋଉ ଆମର ଯୋଉ ଡିଫେକ୍ଟ ଅଛି, ଯୋଉ ଯୋଉ ଅସୁବିଧା ଯାକ ଅଛି, ତାକୁ ହାଉ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ବ୍ରିଙ୍ଗ ଏ ରିଫର୍ମସ୍, ଦାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟ ମେନ୍ ମୋଟୋ. ଏଣ୍ଡ ରିଗାର୍ଡିଂ ଦ ମିନିମମ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍, ରବର୍ଟ ନୋଜିକ୍ ଇନ୍ ହିଜ୍ ବୁକ୍ ଏନାର୍କି ଷ୍ଟେନ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଇଟୋପିଆ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ରେସ୍ ରେ ଜି ଡିପ୍ ରିଜର୍ଭେସନ୍ସ ରିଗାର୍ଡିଂ ଏ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଦାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏଲାଉଡ୍ ଟୁ ଇଣ୍ଟରଭିନ୍ and whole quest for equality. He challenged the anarchy vision of statelessness as well as the welfare oriented intervention. So here he has given minimum state means a small. So here how he has given his interpretation, the here another question is there, another thing is there. He argues that a state that does not anything more than provide services will violate people's right and so cannot be morally legitimate. Try to understand what I am telling. He argues that a state that does not anything more than to provide service, only service, will violate people's right. ଶୁଣ ଗୋଟେ ଜିନିଷ ପିଲାମାନେ, କିଛି କିଏ ଭାବିବନି, ଆମେ 5 ଟଙ୍କିଆ ମିଲ୍ସ ଦେଇଦେଲେ we are not solving the unemployment problem, we are not solving the condition of the poor people. Am I right?
Right, sir.
So he argues that state which is more extensive than the minimum state, then the minimal state is bound to be non neutral by increasing the scope of manipulations. So it is not the duty of the state to do the manipulations. It is very very pity if a state is doing for his nasty politics. It is very very pathetic and it is not a minimum state. So first you try to write what is the motto of the welfare state. Suppose you note it, what is the welfare state, who are the philosophers and what they have proved. In one sentence you write. Then what is the minimal state, who are the philosopher and what is his main motto and what he wants to know. Hala, this is the style of answer writing. Then automatically you write better. Okay, then anything more? Hello.
Yes sir.
Anything more, Samishta? Anusha?
No, sir.
Anusha, anything, yes. Any more you want to ask me?
No, sir.
No, sir. Huh?
No, sir.
After this discussion, we will go to your the assignment questions, what you are asking before me. So I want to have a discussion regarding every chapters. Samishta, have you any question?
Sir, we have already done about our assignment questions.
You will go for it because we have time. So 1 hour we will discuss about the most question. Then after we will go with it. Just simply, yes. I will have a discussion. Okay. Then regarding what are the essential features of the critics of capitalism as propounded by Marx and Engels. So you see the 2.3 page number. So here you will go what the opinion of the Marx and the Engels. Then the next question is, distinguish the pre-1917 critique of capitalism from that of the post-1917 one. So it is a discussion, pre-capitalism and a post-capitalism. So the next is the social structure.
ସାର୍ ସେଇଟା ଟିକେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କଲେନି, ଯୋଉ ପ୍ରି 1917 ଆଉ ପୋଷ୍ଟ 1917
ଟା ଆଉ ଥରେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିବା, ଠିକ ଅଛି କରିବା. କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଜମ୍, ସୋ ବିଫୋର 1917 ୱାଟ୍ ଡିଡ୍ ହ୍ୟାପନ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଆଫ୍ଟର. ଓକେ, ସୋ ବିଫୋର 1917 ଭେରିୟସ୍ ଥିଙ୍କର୍ସ ଲୁକ୍ ଟୁ ଇନୋଭେଟିଭ୍ ଫର୍ମସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ methods of regulating capitalism to achieve changes in a prevailing structure. So, what are the prevailing conditions? So, what they have done after 19, sorry, what were the condition before 1917? They were often inspired by philosophers of the nations. So, my dear friends, one thing I want to know, these are all about the different views of the philosophers. Okay, so among socialist critics of capitalism, many fixed on its unjust character and sought remedies in various forms of social action. Robert Owen, a leading textile manufacturer, focused on the existence of poverty in conditions of abundance. So, before 1917, poverty condition was there. People were not getting proper food. People were not getting the health conditions. Their health condition was very, very miserable. The socio, political, and economic condition was miserable. He explained it as a result of the competition among the capitalists, which led to the technical innovation, sudden falls in the demand for labor, decline in general consumption, and contraction of production. So, at that time, there was a competition among the entrepreneurs. So, automatically, what did happen? Automatically, it changed the society. Automatically, the production was better than before. And in mind, he ran the new Lankan cotton mills on human principles and fostered cooperative communities, new harmony in Indians. The followers of Ricard, Charles Hart, Thompson, the different kinds of associations, following that Darwin Ricard theories, they saw capitalism generating a rent increase spiral that would lead to the impoverishment of the working class. So, when there was a competition among the entrepreneurs, what did happen? It led to the impoverishment of the working class people. The solution they argued was a break on the competition, on the competitive capitalism. So what he told that there shouldn't have any capitalism. This is before 1917. So after 1917, what happened? After the situation seriously changed owing to the First World War, the October Revolution of 1917, and the Depression of 1929, and the Second World War. The World Wars and the Depression undermined the economy of the European states so decisively that capitalism itself came into question. The Bolshevik Revolution in Russia, the Bolshevik factions of the Russian Social Democratic Workers' Party in October 1917 and its success in the civil war that followed provided an example that attracted attention. So then after it has given what the Bolshevik Revolution has brought in. So this is all about the before and after the revolution. So any question? What is that question? Okay, then pre-capitalism, this is all about the pre-1917 capitalism and post-1917 capitalism. Any question? So the next question is 3.2, you see. What are the ways in which human life under modern conditions is different from the earlier times? Do you want to discuss it? The human condition of modern human life in the modern conditions and the form of earlier times. So, Mr. Hello?
I guess so.
Do you want any discussion? I think it is not necessary to have a discussion because we have already discussed the human life under modern conditions and how it is differ from the earlier times. I think it is not necessary. Then the next question is, what is the modern society? It is not a difficult task. How is the process of a secularization a part of a modern social structure? This is interesting. If you want, I will discuss it. Secular.
Yes, sir.
So, what do we mean by secular state? Secular means what? Hello? Pushpanjali?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Dharma. Sir, dharma nirapakya rashtra.
No.
Second one.
Not connected to religion or spirit. Not connected with religious or spiritual matters.
Okay. So, we can say, what is the question? How is the process of a secularization a part of a modern social structure? So, here we will see how secularization came to India. This process of a secularization tends to displace religious institutions. Try to understand, this process of a secularization tends to displace religious institutions, beliefs and practices. What was before? We have the dogmas, we have the superstitions, we are believing only on church. But the secularization tends, it displaces the religious institutions, beliefs and practices in favor of a reason of science. We gave importance to science, not the religion. Okay, the thinkers, the philosophers, they infuse a new thing to the human mind. A process first observable in Europe towards the end of the 17th century. So, what I have told you, so after the downfall of the Constantinople, so a new thought developed in the mind of the people, and they get importance to science and reason, and they didn't try to believe anything only blindly. Although religion has not been driven out from the society, and although the public may hold traditional religious beliefs alongside the scientific ones, religious phenomena have lost their centrality in the life of society as a whole. So when the people, they gave stress, they gave importance to science, automatically the religious dogmas, superstitions and beliefs, automatically it wiped out from the society. This process of rationalization touches capitalist economy with its calculation of profit and loss. It is referred to the establishment of a rational system of laws administration in modern society. So previously there was no laws in the society. There are the working class people, they only got the punishment. But in modern society, it was totally changed. Okay. Political and cultural centralization and informality have been interpreted to creation a mass society, to create a new society. The rise of a totalitarian movement in the 20th century showed that these tendencies were real and present in all modern society, which was not before that. So this is all about the secularization and rationalization. Then industrialism was found to have created a new pocket of poverty. This not necessary. Modern life has seen an increase. Okay. Then this is all about the modernization, secularization, and rationalization. So you will also highlight in modern society, what were the problems of the modern society, how modern society has brought new problems like matching social progress with social pathology. Modern life has seen an increase in suicide, crime and mental disorder. These are the problems of the modern society. But secularization means we will see there is a no gap between the rich and the poor. The poor people also got the poor people also come to a better position than before. Okay. Then anything? I think there is no question. Then next question is, you see page number 15. What do you mean by bureaucratization in modern world? What are the different form of bureaucracy? What are the elements that different type of bureaucracies have in common? Okay, will you want to discuss it, my dear friends? Usaja. Usaja.
Yes, sir.
Do you want to have a discussion? What do you mean by bureaucratization in the modern world? I think it is already we have discussed. We will go ahead. Or you want to have a discussion?
Sir, I have no doubt regarding this. If anyone else have this.
Okay, then Samista.
No sir.
Yes sir. No sir. Huh?
Yes sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Then the next question is, differentiate between the ancient and the modern forms of democracy. I think this there is no doubt of it. Briefly discuss the historical process of democratization. What are the problems with the principles of democracy? Outline different schools, criticism in this respect. What are the contemporary concerns of democratic politics? So I think in democracy chapter, it is already we have discussed, so nothing is new, what I think. Anusha and I.
Sir, got a question. Assignment re bureaucratization bishare. Question to kahi bhi. Bureaucratization bishare got a question achi assignment re. Analyze the process of a bureaucratization in the modern world.
This is number two question. Briefly discuss the historical process of a democratization. Kya anusha patar thilo na samista patar thilo?
Samista sir.
Eta bujhle na nahi. Tame bartan dekhabo page number 26. Here it is a question number two. Briefly discuss the historical process of what now gota kaam karo assignment question ja gota bahar karo ame discussion kariba. I think you have some problems in the assignment questions. I think so you give me assignment questions. Samista, hello.
Yes sir.
You give me the assignment questions number 1.
Yes, sir.
How many questions are there?
Sir,
10 questions.
10 sir.
10 questions.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
You read the first question.
Sir, discuss the differences the capitalist and the socialist pattern of industrialization.
Okay. what is the difficulties with you? Tell me.
Sir, how will
you read? Already discussed.
Kemti lekhibu sir process to ti koibe.
Yes, you tell me the page number and I will tell you.
Unit 12 and 13, sir.
12 and 13, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Which unit number? Unit number, you tell me, because I'm not able to.
12.
Question number 12.
Unit 12.
Unit 12. Okay.
Yes,
Sir, block 4 be continued.
Unit block. Capitalist industrialization, what I think, 22 page.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello? 22 page, sir?
Yes, sir.
Unit block, capitalist industrialization. What is your question?
Discuss.
Tell me. Discuss?
Discuss and differ.
Not hear what I think. Discuss, yes, discuss the process of a capitalist industrialization.
Discuss and differentiate the capitalist and the social. Discuss and differentiate the capitalist and the socialist pattern in pattern of industrialization.
Acha, capitalist and
socialist.
Yes, sir. So, acha. So, here we will see. First, we will see capitalism, and capitalist industrialism, and then after we will come to different paths of industrialization like Britain, France, Germany, and the capitalist entrepreneur. This is all about the whole answer. Okay, the question which you told me regarding the process of a capitalist and differentiate it.
Socially.
What is the question again? What is that? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Hello?
Let me tell something towards my students. Actually, capitalism is a concept which is derived from a group of capitalist theorists, and they presented that the industries when owned by a group of capitalists having wealth, and their question arises inequal distribution of wealth and resources, because when capitalism existed, so it differentiated or divided the society into two groups, that is capitalist and labor class. But whereas socialist means it believes in equal distribution of wealth and resources. All people are equal. Whatever the resources we will have, whatever the profit we will have, it will be distributed equally to all the people, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, whatever it may be. Another concept is that anybody can have a share in socialist theory of industrialization. But in the case of capitalism.
Sir? Yes? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, my dear friends, we will see a capitalist system.
Two types of theory. It was propounded or it came into existence. One is capitalist theory and another is socialist theory. This is the concept actually the student should know.
Sir. Again, I will discuss it, sir.
Sir, one thing.
Or not necessary.
Sir, one thing.
Okay.
Sir, why we compare this capitalism and socialism?
Okay. So, first we have to know what is capitalism. we have made a detailed discussion. So before that, I am telling one thing. An economic and a political system in which a country's trade and industry are controlled by private owners for profit rather than by the state. So in my previous class, I have told you what is capitalism. Capitalism means an economic and a political system in which a country's trade and industry are controlled by private owners for profit rather than by the state. So the private ownership of capital in the hands of a class, the class of a capitalist, to the exclusion of a mass of population, which is a central feature of capitalism as a mode of production. Capitalism is more recent than the capitalist. Capitalism is rarely used by non-Marxist school of economies. So production for sale, it is production for sale rather than own use by numerous producers. Secondly, the characteristics of the capitalism. Secondly, a market where labor power too is a commodity and is bought and sold, the mode of exchange being money, wages for a period of time. The existence of market for labor contrasts with its absence in either slavery or serfdom, which I have told in my earlier class. The predominant universal mediation exchange by the use of money, this aspect, the importance of banks and other financial intermediary institutions. The capitalist controls the production process. This implies control not only over hiring and firing workers, but also over the choice of the techniques. Then, controlled by the capitalist financial decisions, the universal use of money and credit facilitates the other people resources to finance accumulation. This competition between the capitalist of individual capitalist over the labor financial structure is modified by the constant operation of an environment of competition with the other capitalistic either producing. So these are all about the capitalism. So I will say about the capitalist industrialization. Then we will see its impact the socialization. So capitalism is the first stage in the history of the world to coincide with the phenomena of industrialization. Without capital, there is no question of industrialization. Together, the new economic institutions and technical progress is the most essential characteristics of capital advance. It augments the quality of natural resources and labor power and has impact on the trade. Some scholars regard the application of science to industry. It distinguishes characteristics of a modern industry. In the 18th century dawn, the modern industry, the body of scientific knowledge, was too big to be applied directly to industrial process. With the flowering of chemical and electrical sciences, the scientific theory provided the foundation for a new process and a new industries. So, my dear friends, during the 18th century, increase in the use of water power occurred in industries, grain milling, textiles, and metallurgy. The most important development in the application of energy in the early stage of industrialization involved of coal for wood, charcoal as a fuel, and the introduction of the steam engine for the use of mining, manufacturing, and transformation. So, without capital, we cannot think of the industrialization. So, the industrialization brought a tremendous change of the society. In the society, before the industrialization, what happened? There was three class of people. One is the rich class, second is the middle class, and third is the labor class. So nowadays, after the industrialization, after the introduction of the capitalism in the society, what happened? There was no disparity between the different kinds of people. Now, the middle class people are the lone group, which I have already discussed, and they know the techniques how to operate the industry, and they are the qualified persons of the society. And after the industrial revolution, what happened? After the introduction of the industries, what happened? The working class people also now they are much better than before. They didn't depend upon on the rich people, because now they have enough money and they have working hours of hours gradually lower and lower. Now they are working only 8 hours per day, and now they have now they are in a better position what they are before. So this is all about the capitalism, socialism, and the industry, what you have asked the question. Sharmista?
Yes, sir.
You have also asked, you can also the different theories like Adam Smith, what he has told, Adam Smith, Karl Marx, like this. Then Immanuel Wallerstein, these are the opinions of the opinions on the industrial society. You can also note it. Then anything
okay,
more?
Sir.
Anything?
Next question.
So
sir, next question.
One thing, Samita, you do better. You give me a photocopy of your assignment questions. Okay. You
how
today.
Sir, please?
I will give you my WhatsApp number.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you have 9777. Note down.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Look, 9777.
Yes, sir.
20.
Yes, sir.
2063.
2063.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
You give me your number. It may I will also remember you.
Sir, mu send kar douchi ebe apan dekhi diu.
Ha, thik ache. Ebe karta na karibo.
Apan jodi kahibe.
Kar dele mane mu metal paper bhi what I will do. What I will tell you, I will have a paper for that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. 9777. You note down again. 9777002063.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Huh. Then next question. What you are telling?
Next question. How did the Enlightenment influence the socio-economic order in Europe?
How did the Enlightenment? No. Okay.
We have already discussed about it.
We have already discussed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, not necessary. Yeah? Thank you. Then
next sir, analyze.
Sir, assignment question ta kali discussion karibe ki mu apunku pathai debi question ta apun dekhi kali discussion karibe.
Ha, discussion author kar do better hobo seta. Kaina mu ta apra question la kichi janni na. Ta apra kichi koibi ta apra point jam note kar debi ta mu koi debi better hobo seta.
Yes, sir. Next, analyze the process of bureaucratization in modern world. Define modern society. Explain new developments in social structure.
Society is which unit? I have already discussed.
Unit 6.
Unit 6. Yeah, just I am going. Yes. Yes. Again, you tell the question. Discuss.
Define modern society. Explain new development in social structure.
New development. Yes, I will discuss it. So, my dear friends, my dear colleagues, try to listen, listen it. So, a distinction may be drawn between agrarian, industry, rural, and urban. So, I have already discussed with you what is the agrarian society, pre-agrarian society, and industrial society. We have already discussed. No. Yes, so, agrarian, yes. Pre-agrarian, and industrial society, and rural, and urban. Modernization may be viewed a individualization, specialization, and abstraction. Three points I have already discussed. This structure of a modern society takes either a basic unity of individual rather than group community. It is an individual. First, we have stressed, we have given importance on individualization. Okay, the structure of a modern society take as the basic unity the individual rather than the group or community. Okay, so modern society give importance to individualization. Next is the socialization. What techniques he or she had? Then the abstraction, which is generally rules and it is governed by the rules and regulations. The modern society requires three criteria, what I have already discussed. After the advent of the Industrial Revolution, the classification of landlord and peasant began to be supplemented by that of a capitalist and a worker. So after the industrialization, what happened of the modern society? So gradually, the working class people, they changed a lot. The injustice, it came to an end. So this is the present condition of the modern society. The Industrial Revolution of 18th century engendered certain changes. There was a rapid population explosion and empowerment of public health and food supply brought about a drastic reduction of the death rate and by no corresponding decline of the birth rate. So what happened in a modern society? There is no death rate. There is an explosion of the human resources. This contributed a populous explosion in the 19th century. The developing societies experienced rapid population growth after 1945. Economic growth became the defining feature of modern politics. For industrialization, for Western Europe and North America. So what happened in modern society? Economic growth is the main criteria. Most workers came to be employed in the production of manufactured goods and in the services rather than in agriculture. The working class people, they didn't want to remain more in the fields, in the agrarian fields, rather they want to work in the factories or industries. Industrialization brings the growth in trade and manufactures. It requires centralized sites of production, distribution, exchange, and credit. It demands a regular system of communication and transport. So what happened? Gradually, the lifestyle of the modern society changed. As the economic condition was much better than before. So in all over the world, in all over the European society, the social structure was totally changed. So in the United States, in 1800, only 6% of the population lived in towns. And in 1920, the census says it is more than half of the American people live in cities. By the mid-1980s, it rises to nearly 75% of Japan's population. So gradually, population explode in the cities, and they didn't want to remain more in the rural, in the rurals or in villages. So, did you satisfy? Did you satisfy, Samista? What you have asked me the question, or Anusha, who asked me this question? Are you able to listen me, Anusha? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Are you able to understand these points, or anything more to know? Hello, Samista. Hello.
Yes, sir.
बुझेला तो मॉडर्न सोसाइटी कौन कौन तो पता थे लो कुछ दिन ना कौन रही है ला बिकॉज़ तो कुछ नहीं थी नॉट इन माय हैंड सो आई एम नॉट एबल टू गो द फर्दर पॉइंट्स डिटेल इफ दर क्वेश्चन इज विथ मी देन इट वुड बेटर टू हैव ए डिटेल डिस्कशन ओके
ओके सर
ओके देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. This is the direct question. I think there is no problem. There will be no problem of it. Then any question?
Next short notes, question number 5. First, okay. Humanism. Humanism, we have already discussed about it. The liberal view of state, we have discussed about it. And theories of nationalism, discussion.
Okay.
The new economic policy.
In which it is, which unit this is? I think we have already discussed the economic policy. We have already discussed or not? It is no content. So, and I have also no question. So that is the problem. Have you gone through which unity?
Sir.
Okay.
Hello.
Oh, okay.
Sir, I have already said. Sir, I WhatsApp upon go potty reach a question. The condo.
Then it is a corner when a mobile dam will load cottage though. Then wait, I'm a colleague discussion career. The hard oil, a colleague discussion career.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
The new economic policy, you can see unit 6.3, economic and demographic changes.
Which unit, sir?
Unit 6. That means new economic changes means the demographic changes, that means the change of the population, then the position of the urbanization, how the modern society developed, how the industries became main responsible for the growth and development of the urbanization, then the changes of working lives and social structure. So this is all about the new economic life. Then the modernization, secularization and racialization, it is the impact of all economic life. Okay, or we want any discussion? So, my dear friends, you do one thing. Hello?
Yes, sir.
The next question?
Next session B. Question number 2. Discuss the legacy of French Revolution and the Russian Revolution for polity. In the modern world.
So, इटा तो आमे तो discussion कॉल नहीं पकड़ रहे, आउ इटा तो इतना चाहे मैं मुकाले इटा discussion तो कॉल नहीं पाई, किंतु मुझे दिन सोच दिखाऊँ ना, इटा तो आमे difficult की, बोले इटा चैप्टर मुकाले इटा रखी भी पढ़े देगी, ना difficult नहीं हो, हेलो, অনুসয়া
यस सर
हेलो
এইটা তোমরা চাও স্যার কালি অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট ভাই আপনি কালি রাখুন তো আপনি দেখে দেখি কি আমাকে কইবে কোডা কেমন লিখিলে ভালো হবে
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে ও অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট আমি কালি রাখছি কিন্তু কোশ্চেন বাবা আসলে তো কোশ্চেন আসছে তো
হ্যাঁ স্যার হ্যাঁ আসছে
সবরে আসছে তো ঠিক আছে হ্যাঁ হলা এলা কালি এটা ডিসকাশন করি আজ বর্তমান কোন করি কো উই হ্যাভ স্টিল নিয়ারলি হাফ এন আওয়ার
স্যার প্রিভিয়াস তো যে ইউনিট আছে কোশ্চেন ডিসকাশন করিবা কি
হুম কর দেবা বর্তমান তুমি আস ইউনিট 8
ସାର ସେ ରହି ଯାଇଥିଲା ଯେ ୟୁନିଟ ଗୁଡିକ ସେଗୁଡିକ ବି ଡିସକସନ କରିଦେଲେ ଏବେ କିଛିଟା ଚଳିଯିବ
ୟୁନିଟ 8 କି ତମେ ଆସ ପେଜ ନମ୍ବର 26 ଜଷ୍ଟ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ଦ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସ ଏଣ୍ଡ ମାଇ ନେକ୍ସଟ ପିରିୟଡ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଡିସକସ୍ ଏବାଉଟ ୟୋର ଦ ଏବାଉଟ ୟୋର କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ସ ଓକେ हेलो अनुसया
यस सर
हाँ यू ओपन यूनिट 8
यस सर
यूनिट 8 पेज 26
यस सर
ओके सर मिस्टर हेलो हेलो
हाँ सर कौन तो
हाँ वर्तमान में देखिबा डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द एंशिएंट एंड मॉडर्न फॉर्म ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी ओके आई थिंक यू हैव वेल अंडरस्टूड दिस चैप्टर काहे कि ना आमे जो फास्ट देखिथिले डेमोक्रेसी इन एंशिएंट एंड मॉडर्न सो democracy, how it is originated, so what happened in Athens, the what is the motto of the Athenian democracy, it was setting all over the year, nearly 300 days out of 365 days to talk out the plans. It is during the ancient period, or I will go to detail. हेलो हेलो
यस सर
हेलो ओके उषा जा व्हाट ओके हेलो
यस सर
हां लोपामुद्रा व्हाट
यस सर
ओके सो ड्यूरिंग एथेनियन डेमोक्रेसी डायरेक्ट पार्टिसिपेशन बाय सिटीजंस इन द असेंबली took decisions on all policy matters and met on as many as 300 days in the year. Citizens also participated directly in government, chosen by lot to serve in official and administrative and judicial position. So during ancient period in Athenian democracy, what happened? It was sitting not less than 300 years per year out of 365 days, and they took all the decisions in government and official matters. But the democracy in the modern world is not merely the story of evolution of democratic institutions in the course of the 19th and 20th century, and understanding modern democracy is not possible without an account of the social and political ideas. So, in modern democracy, was the result of a complex process of ideological, social, and economic change. Britain changes was by the Industrial Revolution that began in the middle of the 18th century, while in France and America, it was launched by the political revolutions in the last quarter of the same. So, what happened actually? Democracy, what was in the ancient period? and in modern period it was totally changed. So in Britain the change came after industrial revolution, so also in France after the French revolution, and so also in America after civil war. So democracy is a gradual process, so it is changed according to the society, according to the custom, according to the economical life of the people. So it is democratization. So gradually it is changing from day to day, not until 1921. You see, in some places the women, they are also not getting their franchise to cast their vote. Particularly I have told you the two countries like Kuwait or anything. These two countries till now they have not got their franchise. I have forgotten the country's name. You will see it in some places, in some countries, the women also not achieved how to cast their votes. It is already discussed with you. The political ideas of Levelers, John Locke, Tom Paine, and documents like the French Declaration of the Rights and the American Declaration of Independence expressed the important ideas and the principles of democracy in the modern world. So gradually it is changing through a different forms and time to time. So we have to see differentiate between the ancient and the modern form of democracy. So you will write some points on the ancient period and some points on the modern period. Then we will see, briefly discuss the historical process of democratization. So how democracy gradually changes, and you show the different process, how it came to Britain, how it came to France, and how it came to Germany, like this, and it's different process. So what I have already discussed with you, so democracy in the modern world is not merely the story of the evolution of democratic institutions in the course of the 20th centuries. An understanding of modern democracy is not possible without the account of the social and political ideas. So it has a different forms, it has a different process, and we have to see democracy and democratization. What is democracy and democratization? So the next is, what are the problems with the principles of democracy? Outline different schools, criticism in this respect. So what are the problems? Problems means, we have already discussed, no? Different schools. So we will come to you will see explaining democracy and democratization. That means democratic principles, how it is changed from time to time. Then democracy and its critics, how they analyze it, how they gradually changes took place. Then contemporary challenges to democracy. We will see how, what are the obstacles, and how different problems, how democracy goes on with the different problems, we will see in this chapter. Then what are the contemporary concerns of democratic politics? Globalization, democratic politics. So we will see which question. I will say this question in my next period. What are the contemporary concerns of democratic
contemporary politics? Challenges to democracy, development, diversity, gender, globalization.
Page number 23. Yes. Contemporary challenges to democracy. Okay, we will show these points: development, diversity, gender, and globalization. This is all about this contemporary concerns about democratic politics. So you ask any question, my dear friends.
Sir, question number 3, problems with the principles of democracy. Sir,
say that question. The critics, they have given different kinds of critics. What are the critics?
Sir, 22.
22 page. 22. Democracy and critics. What are the problems with the principles of democracy? Hello. So here we will see the different opinions. Hello. Kya kono kaujandi? We will see it. This gives him a special position in the liberal tradition as a forerunner of social democracy and the principles of the welfare state. The socialist critique of democracy has its origin in the writings of Karl Marx, whose attitude to democracy was somewhat contradictory or ambivalent. Among the most important critics of democracy were the elite theorists of the late 19th and early 20th centuries, Balfour, Pareto, and Gaetano Mosca, whose ideas struck sympathetic chord in Mussolini's fascist politics. For Mosca, all talks of democracy was ideological hogwash, because the reality was that throughout history, society had always been divided between the elites and the minority. In a democracy, how the society is divided into two parts, that is elites and a minority. Okay. Any question? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we will go to Then we will go to which chapter?
39.
Okay. How was the welfare as practiced in Britain different from that of practiced in Germany? This question? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So we will see what is the position of a welfare state in Britain and what is the position in Germany. I'm just about Britain and the Kiva. Britain the community on the time of Elizabethan. He has introduced through different kinds of poor laws. He has given chariots to the poor. Charitable rooms were constructed. This is all about the Britain's policy. Then in Germany, we will see where it is. Page number 32. Social legislation for social control, Germany under Bismarck. What did happen in Germany? In Europe, German presents an example where a different philosophy helped to determine the nature of the welfare state. In Prussia, systematic efforts were made to provide relief for the poor. the Ryan provisions and on successful attempt had been made in 1824 to restrict working hours of children in factories. So Germany under the leadership of Otto von Bismarck was a firm country to adopt comprehensive social legislation. Bismarck was motivated by political vision glorifying the nation and an economic vision that stressed national self-sufficiency and paternalism. In the Reichstag, he stated clearly that the purpose of enacting legislation to provide insurance against sickness and old age workers. So what happened in Germany? They given insurance to the sick and the old age workers. The workers' health was an important to the nation. The duty of the state, according to Bismarck, was to regulate all aspects of life in the national interest to make the nation strong. It was necessary to help the weaker citizens. So it is all about the Britain and Germany, you will note it. Okay, then hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. That
were propagated on the concept of Werther. The next question, sir.
What were the various ideas that were propagated on the concept of a welfare state? अच्छा देखो वेलफेयर स्टेट कथा कोहला खणी तीन दा देश आसुची ओटला इंग्लैंड जर्मनी एंड जापान ओके सो आमे इंग्लैंड देखले जे किमिति से माने फ्रॉम द टाइम ऑफ क्वीन एलिजाबेथ टू इट आसला ओके एवं जर्मनी देखले से किमिति ना वीक आउ ओल्ड लोक मान पे कोन से माने सुविधा करथिले सो हियर इट इज गिवन द वेलफेयर स्टेट द प्रोसेस ऑफ what were the various ideas that were propagated on the concept of welfare state? So I am going through about the welfare state. So in a pre-modern period, it is argued the individual could only appeal to the church or religious groups, family or the community faced with the poverty or illness and the causes of the poverty seen either in fate or individual failure. So what was before the welfare state? We have to give some examples. So aga kon hotula se kouthula je eta mo bhagye re achi na se kouthula je jauthula church ku je mate kichi to khaiya budhiyo hela eso kotha se kouthula kintu industrialization brought with the economic growth and the growth of the urban centers when an increasing class of people lived in substantial level the modern state began to tackle the social problems that arose out of this through measures. A strong sense of a humanitarian concern, a fear of a social unrest, the body of a legislation developed the welfare state. All citizens were entitled to a variety of social benefits, a minimum wage, access to public health, and schemes were established for social insurance, such as old age pension and unemployment benefits. So these are the criteria of the welfare state. Old age pension, unemployment benefit, minimum wage, then minimum works, then public health. These are the main points of the welfare state. The state moved providing assistance to help the disadvantaged. It took positive steps to reduce income disparities through taxation and speed schemes to benefit those who were economically or socially disadvantaged. So the disadvantaged people also, they were well protected in the welfare state. A contemporary debate about the welfare policies, the United States, Western Europe, as well as in India, over developing countries have been sharp, criticizing the state assistance for removing incentives for work as well as for pressing burden to the state actually. So there were also some critics, those who have condemned the policies of the welfare state, those who have given charities, those who are not imposing taxes like this, because it has given much burden to the state exchequer. Okay, so these are the points you will highlight it. Okay, Pushpanjali.
Yes, sir.
Then the third question you write, what are the welfare measures taken by the Japan? Okay, or I will go with you. Hello? Hello?
No, sir. We can write.
You can write. Japan ideas of welfare were based on an ideology of a benevolent rule. The ruler helped to mitigate the suffering of his people through timely help. This is the motto of the Japanese. Well, okay, who is asking? Any question?
No, sir, continue.
Hello? Continue. Then we will go to the next chapter, nationalism.
Yes, sir, good to you, Eminent. It is called Japan welfare state. I'm going to page number 33, page number 34, jo point would have sub point of the G. Page number 34, 35, 36, the 37th sub point would have the G. So would I include include
Japan don't look like Hobuja Ponja on the Asimana.
Again, sir, that is a sub point of the end of Jantaraji.
The operator may talk briefly the wall, but what had they the wall? Among the 500, among the Kyo Katan Marakochi, whether it is a short note or a full mark question, Takuhi Tamatahu, no talk on you. Okay. Then.
Hello.
Okay. Bully.
Sir, aji kebalo kum question answer discussion hai jina olga kichi. Karon mu join, mane later join koli na, mu first class attend korni. Jani ni kona discussion hai.
Kuch nahi. Aap kuch nahi. Tamne tamar assignment kuch na matlab gatkal ta pasha dar thila mu dekhi thani koko. Question asked, and go go point that I'm a note for you. I'm going to discuss in a live day. Then, what's the reason? Can I tomorrow assignment question? Mukhi Jandi, not given to Mukhoi Kono?
Sorry, sir.
John Colin, I'm with me. You want sounds on the tomorrow? A question answer for you. Prepare, not a came to Korea, class, came to Korea.
Sir,
hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Sir, I'm going to ask you an assignment question to discuss. I'm going to ask you a discussion about the exam. I'm going to ask you a question about the question. I'm going to ask you a question format. I'm going to ask you a question.
Sir, I'm going to ask you a question.
Sir, I'm going to ask you a question. Sir, I'm going to ask you a question.
आप घोटे दिन से सुनो मु कोई दूंची ना वर्तमान कथा ला अमरो पांचरा कुश्ती ने आसुची पांचरा कुश्ती नू कौन हबो अमरो पोस्टे सेक्शन रू आमे लिखिबा घोटे कुश्ती नू मिनिमम दीते लिखिबा आउटे कुश्ती नू आउटे सेक्शन रू आमे तीन डा लिखिबा है ना जो आमे फास्टे जो पांचरा कुश्ती नू लिखिबा If we have a short note, we are giving, we are awarding 9 out of 10. If we have a good note, automatically you will score good marks, and 18 out of 20. If you have a short note, generally, you have a long question, but you don't have a short note. Out of 20, never we will give, never we are awarding 18. Okay, we are awarding 16, 17, but 18 is too difficult. But in short note, it is easy to get. So first, the time come hala, to write the short note. It is number one thing. Second thing, by the rest four answers you have to answer. Okay.
Sir, sir, what a question. আমার যে লং কোশ্চেন আমি প্রেজেন্ট করিবা তো লং কোশ্চেন মানে প্রেজেন্টেশন ফর্মাটটা কেমিতি হবা দরকার যেটা কি ইভালুয়েটর কো টিকে আই ক্যাচিং হবো
হ্যাঁ আই ক্যাচিং হবো শোনা গোটে জিনিস দুইটা কথা মু কৌছি পিলা মানে আই ক্যাচিং হওয়া দরকার এবং সেকেন্ডলি তুমি মধ্য উইথআউট এনি ফিয়ার ইউ হ্যাভ টু রাইট ইট সো গোটে জিনিস হল কোন না ধন্য এবং গোটে কোশ্চেন পচারল ডেমোক্রেসি বুঝাপাল না হলে এ পাঠটা তুমি পড়িল ডেমোক্রেসি ডিটেল পাঠটা তুমি পড়ি দিও পড়িদেলা পরে মূল জিনিস হল আমি যে ডিফরেন্ট ক্রিটিক্স ডিফরেন্ট ফিলোসফার্স এ না যাক হচ্ছে আমার ডিফিকল্ট হিস্ট্রি কেবল না এবং ডেট ইট ইজ ভেরি ডিফিকল্ট টু রিমেম্বর ওকে তেমন এইটা মনে রাখি দেওয়া পরে তুমি লিখিল যে ডেমোক্রেসি ডিফরেন্ট স্টেজেস ডিফরেন্ট প্রসেসেস হু হ্যাজ ওপাইন ডিফরেন্টলি এন্ড ইজ গিভেন ডিফরেন্ট ওপিনিয়নস সে সব লিখি দিল হলে লিখি দেলা পরে কোন হব ইট উইল বি ইজি ফর আস হ্যাঁ এক দ্বিতীয় কথা হচ্ছে রাইটিং মাস্ট বি
স্যার ওয়ান মিনিট স্যার 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 ওয়ান মিনিট স্যার অল দ্য স্টুডেন্টস আর রিকোয়েস্টেড দ্যাট আর সি ভুবনেশ্বর ইজ অর্গানাইজিং ওয়েবিনার অন ইন্টারন্যাশনাল ডে ডে অফ ইয়োগা প্লিজ অল আর রিকোয়েস্টেড টু পার্টিসিপেট ইন দিস সেমিনার অ্যান্ড মেক ইট গ্র্যান্ড সাকসেস সো অল আর রিকোয়েস্টেড আই হ্যাভ অলরেডি শেয়ার দ্য মিটিং আইডি and it will be through the Google Meet. Okay, you will not face any problem. So it will be organized through Google Meet and all are requested to participate in this webinar and this is for you. And all over India, all the students from different parts, different corners of the corners of India, they are participating in the webinar. And please make it grand success. So it is my request to all of you, just right after the class, you just whatever the meeting ID I have shared, so please use that meeting ID and enter into the that webinar. And I'll just because I'll be coordinating this webinar, and I may not be in a position to wind up the program. And before 5 minutes or 2-3 minutes, I end, or you can say before 5 minutes or 5 to 6 minutes, you can wind up the program and join the webinar. This is for you. This is because of the, it is a part of your career development, and you have to listen to the resource persons, and then you can upgrade your knowledge. Please, you are, it is my request to all of you. Please join this webinar. Make it grand success.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, move on. Go ahead, sir.
Just I have already shared this. I have already shared in the WhatsApp. I have already shared and given you the meeting ID and schedule. Okay, sir.
Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, Pushpanjali, hello.
Yes, yes, sir.
कौन पता था लो?
Sir, किसी नहीं किसी पता.
ବହୁତ ଡିଫିକଲ୍ଟ ଟାସ୍କ ଯାକ ଦିଆହେଇଛି ତମକୁ ବଟ୍ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ରାଇଟ୍ ଭେରି ସିମ୍ପଲ୍ ସପୋଜ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ସେ yesterday I went to Igno Center and I met to Pushpanjali Gowda and have a discussion about this. So like this, it should be very clear, very lucid, and it should be very heart-touching. Then only you can write something. So give. So we are always searching the different points. We are not thinking about the language. Okay, I think you followed very well. I am always, they write, the examiners always, they are searching the important points. Whether you have lapsed it, or you have skipped it, or you do not know about the important points.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Whenever you are writing, so give the highlight the important points, and the points must be very simple, by which you can able to write. Okay.
ଯେମିତିକି ଆମର
हाँ हाँ ठीक अच्छे एक जुड़े भल मार्क सब दिखती न किए भी सेवेन टू कम पाँ मुझे भावुची समस्ते अप टू नाइंटी पर्यटन पाँच
सर हमर तमिल लिटरेचरटा बहुत डिफिकल्ट अछि सेटा ठीक डिस्कशन करे देबे
सुनो काल तो लास्ट डे आ बर्तन मते असाइनमेंट क्वेश्चन दे दिलनी मु असाइनमेंट क्वेश्चन आ देखिबी कोन कोन अछि देखिकि तापर मु जिबी आ तमिल क्वेश्चन आ कोड अछि मते कहबो बोले कहले मु देखि देबी कोड कोड अछि इटा केतना मीडिया वाला सुनो एटा काल कि यदि टाइम हबो बोले हम जिबा मीडिया वाला एटा कोड अछि इटा को यूनिटी कोडा कहि परिबो को 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 यूनिटी
सर यूनिट 1 रे अछि
यूनिट 1 ओ यूनिट 1 हम कहि परबिन काईना मते ये नै नै यूनिट 1 ना एमएचआई 1
नै सर एमएचआई 4 रो यूनिट 1
एमएचआई 4 रो ऊपर नै से बहि मो पर नै
एमएचआई 5 सर सर 5
सर वाइंड अप कर दबा हमर से क्लास रहउछि तो
हां कर दबा ठीक है बहुत धन्यवाद है हला
ओबी थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू वेरी मच ओके ओके थैंक यू ছাঁটলু বাপরে বাপু আনলু গুগলে দেখিল ব্লক লিস্ট কম কম আছে এটা ওপেন কর দে ব্লক লিস্ট কর দে দেখি মিশন কম ফোন করতে দেখি
আমরা
দিদা ওপেন কর দে ডিএসএল ওপেন কর দে
প্রিন্সিপাল দিথর ফোন
কর দে কর দে দিদা ওসরা কই কর দে আর গুগল মিট যাই করে করে কর দে চুটু নেই না